Hi, I'm Bob Tabor with www.learnvisualstudio.net. In this module, I'm going to focus on creating a user, and then I'm going to assign that user a few roles. So I made a big deal in the previous module that I was going to create a user off camera, but I decided not to do that. I want to show you how to create that user and then allow that creation process to kind of walk us through some of the decisions we have to make with regards to the roles that we want to give that user. So let's go ahead and create a new user. We're going to create one in the Atris Active Directory, not the Sales Active Directory. And I'll go to the Users tab and click Add User. It'll open up the Add User dialog. And so the first option that we have is to select a type of user. Now, there are three different options here. The first one is to add a new user inside of your own organization. So that indicates that you want to create a new user account and you want it to be created and managed within your directory. So I can create, for example, steve@atris.com with this option. The second option, you want to create a user with an existing Microsoft account. This allows me to add an existing Microsoft account to my directory. So I could add my own Outlook.com account, bobtabor@outlook.com, as a user, as a member of this directory. Now, why would I want to do that? A couple of different reasons. First of all, it would allow somebody outside of the organization to collaborate. Maybe a temporary employee, a consultant, a contractor, or a partner. I might also choose this option because I want to set this new user as the service administrator for the account. So I would later use, like, for example, in fact, I think I'm going to do this. I'll use my son's Outlook.com account, ConradTabor@Outlook.com, in order to set him as the service administrator for the sales account. The reason you have to use, I think I alluded to this before, the reason you have to use a Microsoft account instead of an organizational account as the service administrator for the subscription is because if you were to accidentally delete the organizational user, Conrad or Steve@atris.com, then the whole subscription would be left without a service administrator, and that would be bad. I did this. I had to call support and have them clean it up. So you don't want to do that. Okay, and then finally, there's a third option that you can add a user in another Windows Azure Active Directory directory. So this is similar to the previous option. It allows me to add a user account to my directory that originates from another directory. So even though the sales department wants to have its own Active Directory directory, it still might want to allow certain individuals within the organization that reside in a different Azure Active Directory access to sales-related resources, websites, tools, and things of that nature. All right, so there's a caveat to this last one here, to adding a user from another Azure Active Directory directory. In order to use this option, I would need to be me, bob@atris.onmicrosoft.com, I would have to be a member of that other directory as well in order to select a user in that other directory and add them to this directory, okay? So I would need to be a member of the sales directory in order to add a user from my original directory into the sales directory. All right, so this is where I said at the outset that these are some of the more confusing aspects of Azure to me because there's so many different permutations with regards to accounts and what they can do and how they can be associated. It really is kind of it's challenging. So just know this, that there are rules around what you can do and what you can't do based on your association with a given directory and your role within that directory. So if you think you should be able to do something and you can't do it, then you probably just need to consult MSDN or the Azure Community Forums. The answer is probably pretty simple once you get your head around what really needs to happen in that situation. All right, so in our particular case, what I want to do is just select a new user in an organization. We're going to call this Steve@atris.com. Click Next. Now we'll give him all of his details. And now I have another option to select a role for this user. And let's stop down for a second and talk about roles. There are actually two different categories of roles inside of Azure. There are subscription administrator roles, and there are directory administrator roles. So inside of those categories, there are several different roles. So in a nutshell, the subscription administrator is concerned with managing the services that are associated with a single subscription. So he works at a very high level. A directory administrator is concerned with managing individual users and groups and applications inside of a specific directory. All right, so let's talk about the kinds of things that each of these roles can do. At the outset, I want to stress that directory administrator roles are really not all that useful outside of the narrow list of things that I described that you can actually do with Azure Active Directory. The Azure Active Directory features are not related to creating and managing services in Azure. So this has nothing to do with whether I can create a virtual machine or tear it down. It has nothing to do with can I deploy my Azure website, things of that nature. Again, that is the job of a service administrator or one of the 200 co-administrators. We'll talk about that in just a moment. The directory administrator roles are focused solely on providing access to other things like Office 365 or Intune or third-party apps or custom apps that utilize Azure Active Directory, like we talked about in one of the previous modules. So if you never see yourself or you never see your organization using Azure Active Directory for that purpose, then you can literally just skip everything else in this module and move on. You really don't need to know it. Well, at least you can skip the part about specifically directory administrator roles. Okay, so there are, as you can see, there are 6 different types of roles. I have a great link where you can read more about each one of them here on screen. But basically, the one that's probably the most significant is the global administrator. The global administrator would have access to all administrative features on Office 365 or if it's utilized in something like MailChimp or whatever the case might be. So the person who signs up for the Azure account, as you recall, automatically becomes a global administrator for that default Active Directory. And only global administrators can assign other administrator roles. So that's why I, as bob@atris.onmicrosoft.com, am able to actually create this user and assign this role. There can be more than one global administrator in the organization. I'm going to go ahead and make Steve a global administrator. Now, again, there are a bunch of other administrator roles. Again, take a look at this link to learn more about the different permissions that are available to each. Some of these roles can be a bit confusing. Just remember that this is scoped for the directory, not the entire subscription. So specifically, these are roles that are used to administer Office 365, Intune, third-party applications, and so on. I know this can be a little bit confusing. Just remember, these roles don't affect what really goes on inside of Azure services, like creating virtual machines, web services, storage, things of that nature. Okay? All right, so let's finish this guy up here. And I don't think we need to give him an, sure, why not? steve@atris.com. And we're not gonna enable multi-factor authentication. We'll talk about that much later. Let's continue on. We'll go ahead and get a temporary password for Steve, and we'll copy that. Actually, let me open up Notepad real quick here. And I'm gonna actually pin this to my taskbar so I can get back to it easily. And I'm gonna put steve@atris.com, and I'm going to go ahead and paste in that temporary password. And I could actually send the temporary password in clear text in an email to Steve or one of his accounts, but we're not going to do that for now. All right, so now Steve, the next time that he logs in, maybe we'll do this at the very end, Steve will have to provide a new, stronger password and kind of verify who he is and what he can do. All right, so we've already added steve@atris.com. Now what I want to do is rise above his role inside of this directory, and I want to promote him to become one of the co-administrators of the subscription so that he can add and remove Azure services as he needs to. So what I'm going to do is come down to the services option on the left, and then I'm going to select administrators here, the administrators tab at the top. And then what I want to do at the bottom is click add. And here I'm going to add Steve at atris.com, and I'm going to give him co-administrator rights to, let's just give him administrator rights to the free trial. He's not going to be able to be a co-administrator for the sales subscription. We'll deal with that later. And then I'll click OK. Takes a moment to set him up. And so now we can see Steve is a co-administrator on the free trial subscription. All right, so let's talk about the different kinds of roles that are available for subscription administrators. I think you're familiar with all of them already. There's only three. The first is an account administrator, and then there's also the service administrator, and now co-administrators. So remember what we said at the very outset. We said that account administrators, that there's one per Azure account, and this is the only account that's authorized to access the account center. Like when you go to, you know, view my bill, we've already been to the account center to look at and to set up subscriptions. And he can cancel subscriptions, he can change the billing credit card for a subscription, and so on. He can also change who the service administrator is for that subscription. Then there's the service administrator. Also, there's only one service administrator per Azure subscription. And the service administrator can provision new Azure services for the account. So if you need a new Azure website, he can do it. You need to provision a new Azure table storage account, he can do it. Need to spin up or spin down a virtual machine, he can do it. So that's the job of the service administrator. The service administrator is typically somebody, a developer, a system or network administrator, maybe a technical lead, maybe a VP of IT, whatever the case might be. But it's a technical contact that'll need to authenticate and add and configure various Azure services. And since there's probably quite a few other individuals within the organization that will need to do the exact same thing, the service administrator can designate up to 200 co-administrators who will have that same ability. The difference between a service administrator and a co-administrator is that only a service administrator can add co-administrators. And so while there is only one service administrator, there can be up to 200 co-administrators per subscription. So a co-administrator, again, basically the same. He can set up services. You need a website, you need storage. Talk to one of the co-administrators and they'll be able to set it up for you. Okay, so actually one more thing about this. There's actually a couple of really good diagrams, and the article itself is awesome too at this URL. So you definitely want to check that out. Make sure you fully digest this because there are so many different new terms that are flying around here. All right, finally, what I want to talk about are groups. So let's go back to the Azure Active Directory and we'll select one of the directories. And you can see there's a group option here. We don't have any just yet, but directory users can be added to groups for ease of management to access various subscriptions for that directory. So suppose that you wanted to give a subset of all your directories users access to that homegrown application that we've been talking about here that was designed to use Azure Active Directory. Well, you could create a group, you could add the users to that group, and then you could provide privileges for that group to access the app or even certain parts of the app. So instead of managing each individual user's access to a given resource or multiple resources, you can just put that user into a group. That group has access to all these sorts of things. And now, since he's a member of that group, he gets access to all those sorts of things. All right. All right, so let's stop here and let's recap. In this module, we focused on managing users and giving them roles in Azure for various purposes. We saw how we can add new users to a directory and assign the user a directory administrator role, such as the global administrator. We talked about the various directory roles. We've actually not demonstrated everything that they can do, but keep in mind that they're mostly for the purpose of Office 365 or other third-party services that rely on Azure Active Directory. Then we promoted a user in a directory, steve@hrs.com, to become a co-administrator for the subscription. Now he can log in and he can create services and destroy services for a given subscription. And then finally, we talked about the different subscription administration roles, the account administrator, the service administrator, and then the co-administrators. Got all that? It took me a while to kind of figure all this out. Hopefully it'll be easier for you. Hopefully my explanation helps. All right, let's keep, let's do one more thing before we close it up here. Steve needs to log in and change his password. I just want to show you what that looks like. I think Steve's all ready to go. Let's go ahead and let's log out. Sign in again. Okay, and one thing I wanted to point out here is that if you're ever confused about organizational account versus a Microsoft account, if you see this little badge, that's an organizational account. If you see the Microsoft logo, that's a Microsoft account. So you might see several here as you collect them, as you start administrating your own directories and so forth. Just remember that if you ever get stuck or forget, you can always make that differentiation. All right, so let's use another account. We're gonna go for steve@hrs.com. Hit continue. We'll type in the password. Let's go ahead and copy that password there. And paste that in. Just want you to see what this looks like. It's gonna be asked to provide the old password and then a new, hopefully more secure password. And click submit. All right, and so it recognizes Steve, gives him the familiar Azure tour. Let's go ahead and see what Steve can do here. He can see the directory, and he is a global administrator on that directory, but notice that he can't see the other directory, the Atrus sales directory. Furthermore, Steve can probably add some users to this since he's the global administrator. Whoops, let's go back. Let's just see if he can add a user. He sure can. He can also reset a password for a user. Very cool, because he's a global administrator. Also, since Steve is also a co-administrator, he can create a website. Let's go ahead and just quickly create a website. We'll come back to this later. Atrus, and that should be available. And we'll create a new web hosting plan. We'll talk about all this later. But you can see that he's able to do this as well. Okay, so that is how you create a user and how you allow him to log in and then be able to do things. You've delegated him responsibilities in the system. All right, that's all I wanted to say. We'll see you in the next module. Thank you.